Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial.
If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_027_DIAB where you saved it. You can also download this file on the website. If you don't have access into this file, you can use your own file or sit down and watch.
Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. If you plan to open this drawing in the earlier version of AutoCAD, go ahead and go to the file of type and change to that version. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007. Rename this file to 00_028_DIAB and click the save button. Move your mouse cursor and zoom in into this area. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 3D polyline. At the specified start point of polyline point, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this vertex. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Go to the status bar and turn off the off snap button. Move up and type 6 inches, press enter. Move back, type 1 foot, press enter. Move up, type 6 inches, press enter. Move back and type 1 foot, press enter. Type 3 on your keyboard to close the figure. Go to the visual style control and click realistic. Select the 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude point, select this 3D polyline. Press enter. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction. At the specified height of extrusion point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 5 feet 4 inches on the keyboard. Press enter. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 3D polyline command. Go to the status bar and turn on the object snap. At the specified start point of polyline point, select, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this vertex. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and use the endpoint object snap to snap on this vertex. Move into this direction, type 4 feet 2 inches, press enter. Move back and type 2 feet, press enter. Move to the left, type 4 inches, press enter. Move into this direction, type 1 foot 8 inches, press enter. Move to the left, type 3 feet 6 inches, press enter. Move into this direction and type 1 foot 8 inches, press enter. Type 2 on your keyboard and press enter to close the figure. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude point, select the polyline, that 3D polyline that you just drew. At the select object to extrude point, press enter. Move the mouse cursor up and type 1 foot 6 inches, press enter. Select this step. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At the specified base point point, use the endpoint object snap to snap at the vertex of this step. At the specified second point point, move the mouse cursor and snap into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Now let's change the visual style to realistic. As you can see, we need to close this gap. To close this gap, let's go back to the 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object or bounded area point, click on this face. At the specifying extrusion height point, move the mouse cursor and snap to the vertex of this color. Press escape to get out of the panel. Go to the visual style control and select realistic. Hold down your control key and type S on your keyboard to save your. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 3D polyline. At the specified start point of polyline point, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this corner. Move the mouse cursor into this direction, type 3 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Move the mouse up, type 7.5 inches. Press enter. Move the mouse back, type 1 foot. Press enter. Move the mouse up, type 7.5. Press enter. Move the mouse back. Go and turn off the post map on the status bar. Move the mouse back, type 1 foot. Press enter. Move the mouse up, type 7.5. Press enter. Move the mouse back, type 1 foot. Press enter. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Select this 3D polyline. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. At the Specify base point prompt, go and turn on the object snap and use the endpoint object snap and snap this object into this corner. At the Specify second point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the corner. Go to the visual control, click realistic, select the 2D wireframe. Select the 3D polyline that you just copied. Type 3D, rotate on your keyboard. Press enter. At the specified base point front, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this corner. At the peak a rotation axis, click this red circle. At the specified angle start point or type an angle prompt, move the mouse cursor into this area and click. Then, move the mouse cursor into this area and click. AutoCAD rotate the object and end the command. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the Extrude command. At the Select Object Extrude prompt, select this polyline, press Enter. Now move the mouse cursor and snap into this vertex. Press enter to repeat the extrude command again. Select this polyline, press enter. At the specifying extrusion height, select this vertex. Select the solid that you just draw. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Press down your middle mouse button to pan the drawing to the right and orbit to get a better orientation. Now at the specifying base point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this vertex. At the specified second point prompt, move your mouse cursor and snap into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the panel. Go to the visual style control and click the 2D wireframe, select realistic. Orbit the drawing into this area to get a better orientation. Zoom in. Select this step. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specifying base point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this area. At the specified second point prompt, zoom in into this area and snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style control and change it to 2D wireframe. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the press P command. At the Select Object or Bounded Area prompt, click this face. At the Specify Height of Extrusion prompt, move the mouse cursor into this area and snap into this area to press the solid. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the Visual Control and change your model back to Realistic. Hold down your Shift key and orbit around to the front. Go to the Home tab, Draw Panel, and select the Line command. At the specified start point of the line, use the endpoint of this solid and click. At the specified next point, move the mouse cursor up and type 9 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. At the specified next point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 4 feet 3 inches. Press enter. At the specified next point, move the mouse cursor down, type 9 feet. Press enter. Type C on your keyboard and press enter to close the figure. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the freeze layer button. Freeze this foundation and this lab, this wall, this column. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now use a window selection.
select from this point to this point. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, isolate objects. Right click the UCS and select objects. At the select objects prompt, click on this line. Right click the UCS again and select rotate axis. Select the X axis. Now move the mouse cursor to the top until the right facing right of the screen. Click. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At the specify offset distance prompt, type 1 foot, 4 inches, press enter. Select this object and offset it inside. Select this object and offset it inside. Select this object, move up, type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At the specified face point prompt, use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this line. At the specified next point prompt, move the mouse cursor and use the midpoint or perpendicular object snap and snap into this point. Press escape to get out of the line command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Select this line and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Zoom in into this area and click here. Use a crossing window and click to trim off this object. Now, if you look at the command line, you see the prompts. Select object to trim or shift to extend or fence, crossing, project, edge, erase, undo. These are all options that are associated with the trim command. So type R on your keyboard to use the erase option, or you move your mouse cursor and click the erase on the command line. Now select this object. When you select this option, AutoCAD allows you to select any object that you want to erase. You can select as many objects as you can. When you press enter, AutoCAD end the erase transparent command and return you back to the trim mode. Now press enter to erase the object. As you can see, AutoCAD erase the object and return you to the trim mode. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent button. Now type join on your keyboard and press enter. Add a selectors object or multiple objects to join at once prompt. Use a window selection and select all these lines. At the select object to join prompt, press enter. AutoCAD convert this object into one polyline. Again, we need to get an opening into this area and join this object to this one. Go to the home tab and click the down arrow next to the modify panel. Select the break command. At the select object to break prompt, move your mouse cursor and hover it into this area. Now at the specify second breakpoint point, move your mouse cursor and click here. AutoCAD break the line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. At the select object prompt, select this line and this. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, click on this grip. When it's turned red, move it and snap it to the end point of this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Type join on the keyboard and press enter. At the select object or multiple object to join at one point, use a crossing window selection and select this object. Press enter. Try to select this object. As you can see, AutoCAD convert this object into polyline. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude prompt, select the external polyline. At the select object to extrude prompt, select the internal polyline. Press enter. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 9 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. AutoCAD extrude the two polyline into solid. Go to the visual style control and click realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the subtract command. At the select object point, select the external solid and press enter. At the select object point, select the internal solid, press enter. AutoCAD subtract the internal solid from the external solid. Go to the visual style control and click the 2D wireframe, select realistic. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the previous. When you use this option, AutoCAD places you from the previous state layer. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the match property. At the select source object point, select this column. At the select destination object point, select this column. Press enter to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer property. This will bring the layer property manager. Click the new button. Rename this layer to step. And click the color swatches. In the select color dialog box, select any color that you want to give to your step. I'm going to select the index color 33 and click OK. Click the new layer button again to get another layer. I'm going to rename this layer to F port. Click the color swatches to change each color. I'm going to select the index color 127. Close the layer properties manager. Select this step, go to the quick access toolbar and select the step layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this solid. Go to the quick access toolbar and move this solid into the F port. Press escape. Hold down your shift key and orbit. Select this step, and go to the home tab, layer panel. Move this object to the step layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified first point point, zoom in into this area and use the endpoint object snap. Snap from this area and move the mouse cursor. Type 1 foot on your keyboard. Press enter. Escape to get out of the command. Hold down your shift key and orbit. Right click the UCS and select wall. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline. At the specified start point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this endpoint. Now move the mouse cursor, type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Hold down your shift key and orbit. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and use the endpoint object snap. Snap into this area. Move the mouse cursor and snap here. Type C on your keyboard and close the figure. Go to the visual style control and change the visual style to 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. At the select object on the layer to be isolated, select this polyline. Press enter. AutoCAD isolate this polyline. Now use a window selection to select around this area and erase the reference line that we draw before we create the polyline. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude point, select this polyline, press enter. Move the mouse cursor into the positive Z direction and type 6 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the on isolate button. Go to the visual control, click the 2D wireframe, select realistic. Zoom out, go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object point, select this step. At the select destination object point, zoom in into this area and select this solid. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, and hit delete on your keyboard. Alright, in this tutorial, we create some step and flower pot and the remaining color. In the next tutorial, we will continue and model the internal stairs. If you found this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends.
If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along on this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.